For calling the suicide hotline.
Is this a person?
Our operators are experiencing a high call volume. I will be glad to assist you.
I'd really rather talk to...
We will connect you with an operator shortly. If this is a serious threat, press 1. If your suicidal feelings are due to recent divorce, press 1. For bankruptcy or other economic factors, press 2. For depression or existential ennui, press 3.
What?
For romantic trauma, press 5. If you plan to use a gun, press 1.
Listen.
Or a tall building, press 2.
All I want...
This is a case of autoerotic asphyxiation, press 3.
What's autoerotic... I don't want to press any more numbers.
In the meanwhile, here are some great reasons to go on living. Sunsets. Candy. The sound of the beach. Newborn baby pandas. The song Cracklin' Rosie by Neil Diamond.
I don't like Neil Diamond.
Everybody likes Neil Diamond.
I want to talk to a person right now.
Connecting.
Lifesavers Incorporated, this is Stan speaking.
Thank God. Thought I was going to have to talk to that machine.
Gotcha. No one named Stan even works here.
This isn't funny.
Calm down. It hurts me to hear this kind of distress in your voice. Although I must say, you sound like a surprisingly attractive woman.
Are you hitting on me?
Of course not. That would be against the ethics of Lifesavers Incorporated, as well as an affront to the personal distress you must currently be experiencing. I'm a Capricorn. How about you?
Oh, for fuck's sakes.
What are you wearing?
Listen, buddy. This has been a bad month. Are you listening to me?
Yes.
Good. Because 3 weeks ago, Steve moved out. He was my fiancé. We've been together ever since junior year prom.
Tell me more.
We went to the dance in this stretch Hummer limo. We looked so much hotter than everyone else. And afterwards, just before we had sex, he bought me 4 Bacardi Breezers and told me he loved me.
Oh, that's adorable.
Things were supposed to go so well after high school, you know? But then I couldn't get any acting work, and Steve lost our life savings on that fantasy football tournament. And then the bastard left me for that effeminate Puerto Rican from Survivor who betrayed Linda in the 7th round elimination challenge.
I remember him. He was hot.
I know!
Don't cry, ma'am. I understand.
You do?
Most definitely. Especially when combined with recent heartbreak, the current economic situation in this country would be enough to drive anyone to breaking point. Can I borrow $60?
What?
Just till Tuesday.
You're not getting shit!
It's not my fault. My boogie said it was a sure thing to bet against the Globetrotters.
Then you're both idiots. Listen, pal, you're not getting a dime out of me.
You seem to forget. We have caller ID.
So?
I know where you live, bitch.
That's it.
To continue dying, press 1. See you in hell, fuckers. For super babies, press 3.